Hey guys, this is Abhishek from gadgetshow.com, and today we are going to do a full review of LG Nexus 4. It has been now available in India for a price of around 25,000 to 26,000 Indian rupees. Now before we start our review, let's take a look over the device. So here we have the device, and the device has a glass display at the front, and at the back as well it also have a glass, and it does have a kind of a textured design which you can easily notice at the back side. And again, because of the glass back, it does attract some fingerprints over time. You have the loudspeaker over here, you have the Nexus branding over here, LG branding over here, you have the 8 megapixel camera over here with LED flash. On the top you have the secondary mic for noise cancellation and video chat. You have the 3.5mm audio jack. Here you have the volume rocker on the left side on the top. Here you have the SIM card slot, so it will accept a micro SIM, and the SIM ejection tool does come within the package, so you can eject the SIM tray and insert the SIM card. And at the bottom you have the micro USB port for data syncing and charging. Here you also have the mic for voice calling. And you do have two screws which are actually binding this phone together, so the battery is non-removable on this device. And we will tell you about the heating issues of the device as well. And you have the power and sleep key over here, as you can see, and that's it. On the front we have the nice earpiece over here, if you can see it. And you have the front camera, which is a 2 megapixel camera, again fixed focus camera. The back camera is 8 megapixel and it is autofocus. At the front, at the bottom, you have the touch capacitive buttons which are there within the screen, so it does affect the overall resolution of the phone sometimes in some of the application, but not all. And you have nothing over here, so everything here which you see over here is nothing but a wastage of the space. Talking about the physical design of this phone is quite nicely designed. You have nice quality of material which has been used while manufacturing this phone. On the edges you have a kind of a plastic material which does give you a kind of a good grip into your hand, because it has a rubberized finish to it. At the back you have the glass back, which again feels good, but it will attract the fingerprints over time. If we talk about the form factor of the phone is quite good to hold in one hand. It, because of the kind of tempered edges over here, it becomes quite easy to hold in one hand. It feels pretty comfortable. As far as the thickness of the phone is concerned, the phone is around 9.1 mm thick across this edge, and the weight of the phone is 139 grams, which is again fairly light for a device of this size. As far as the display is concerned, it has a 4.7 inch of display, which is a high definition display, and the resolution of the display is 768 into 1280. So you have that kind of display, and if we take a closer look over the display, you won't see any pixelation with the naked eyes, and the display is quite good in terms of the overall colors. As far as the viewing angles of this display are concerned, the viewing angles for the display are quite wide, if not very extreme. Again, you might see some kind of color fading happening if you view the screen from extreme viewing angles like this. One thing I would like to correct is that the front camera is a 1.3 megapixel camera. It is not a 2 megapixel camera, and it is again a fixed focus camera. When it comes to the processor which we have on this device, we have a quad core 1.5 gigahertz Snapdragon processor. The chipset is APQ8064, and the GPU which we have on the device is Adreno 320, which is quite a decent GPU for graphic. Now one thing I would like to tell you is that the back camera on this device can record high definition videos at 720p as well as at 1080p, and both at 30 frames per second. Now let's take a look over the internal storage and the RAM. If we take a look over the version of Android, it seems to be running Android 4.2, and let me just check out the exact version of Android which this device is running. So it is running 4.2.2, which is the latest version of Android as of now. So here we have the device. The device has 16 GB of internal storage, and out of which around 12.92 GB is actually available to the user for installing applications, for storing picture, videos and other data. We do not have any support for micro SD memory card. When it comes to the wallpaper support, it supports live wallpapers, static wallpapers, but it does not support video wallpapers. Also have automatic brightness supported on this device. Now, as far as RAM is concerned, this device has 2 GB of RAM, which is quite good. and the normal free RAM which is available on the device out of the box is 1.5 GB, which is fairly good if you want to install more applications or if you want to run high graphic intensive game. This phone is capable of running almost all the graphic intensive game. And as far as the UI which I see on this device is stock Android. I do not see any kind of customization on this device, again because this is a Nexus device, so most all the applications are stock Android. I do not see any kind of branding from LG. If we talk about the home screen, we have like 5 home screens which you cannot increase or decrease. Come to the applications which come pre-installed on the device, you have Google Chrome pre-installed, you have Google Currents pre-installed, so you have all the regular application pre-installed. Apart from that, you also get some extra applications like Google Plus pre-installed on this device. Now the touchscreen is as responsive as you see on any other Android phone, and let me just play the Temple Run OZ game to show you the responsiveness of the touchscreen. So as you can see, the game is running fine in terms of the graphics. I do not notice any lag in the graphics, and the touchscreen is also pretty responsive while playing this game. So there is no issue as far as the playback of this game is concerned. Let me just test the sensors on this device. Let me just test the gravity sensor. So as you can see, the gravity sensor is also working pretty fine without any problem on this device. Now this is how the camera UI looks like, and if we go to the photo mode, if you want to access the settings, you have to tap on the screen and then you will see all the settings for toggling the front camera. You have the HDR mode supported, you can turn on and turn off the flash, you can control the exposure from here, and over here you have other settings for the white balance. And if you go into settings, you have some scene selection mode as well, and the picture size can be 8 megapixel maximum. And if you go to the video mode, let me just check out the settings for the videos. So when it comes to video, you can record 720p video or a 1080p video on this device. Okay, you do have photosphere option supported on this device. You can also take panorama shots with this device, and let me just go to the normal photo mode and let me just take a photo of my phone over here to show you the overall quality when it comes to taking photos. And you do have tap to focus, so let me just show you this photo to you. And in order to show the photo, you just need to swipe it like this, and this is how the photo quality looks like on this device. So when it comes to pinch to zoom while previewing a photo, it is not very fluid or smooth, which is something which I don't like about this device. As you can see, it is not very fluid, but again it works. So when it comes to this particular photo, the colors in this photo are looking pretty good, and the details are also pretty fine, unless if I zoom the photo to a very high level. As you can see, you will see some noise. Now this is how the phone dial looks like, and again it is very easy and big in terms of the numbers, so there is no problem as far as dialing numbers is concerned. But I do not see any option of making a video call from this device, either over here in the phone dialer, or even if I go to a specific contact, I do not find the option of making a video call to a. So this is how the keyboard looks like, and this keyboard does have all the features which you would expect in a keyboard which runs on an Android 4.2 device. It does have swipe to type, so you do have continuous input supported on this device, which is pretty good. As far as the keys of the keyboard are concerned, they are pretty big in size and adequately spaced from each other, so we did not face any problem while typing on this device. It does support landscape mode in most of the applications, so in case. As far as widgets are concerned, I do not notice any specific widget which is designed from LG for this specific device. All the widgets which I see are a part of Android 4.2. Now one thing which I like about this device is that this device does not have the stock Android browser, and the stock Android browser here in this case on this device is Google Chrome, and Google Chrome is pretty good browser when it comes to browsing web. So there is no. As you can see, the browser has actually loaded our website, and there is no problem with the kinetic scrolling. As you can see, it is pretty smooth, there is no issue at all. Pinch to zoom is quite fluid, not very smooth, which I don't like about this device. And rendering of the text is rendered pretty crisp and clear on this device, on this display in the browser. And double tap to zoom works pretty fine without any issues, and panning is again pretty smooth without any problem, as you can see on this device. Basically, we are trying to play a high definition video on this device, and this is again from our channel, and the video is getting played in the high definition format again because of the good resolution of this device. And when it comes to playing the YouTube video, it is playing in the full resolution, as you can see over here. And these touch capacitor buttons automatically hide themselves. I do notice some kind of black bars above and below the video, but there is nothing on the right on left hand side. And let me just increase the volume.
And some of those specifications are a little above than the E116 specification.
So the loudness from the loudspeaker is quite loud when it comes to playing YouTube videos on this device or any other kind of video. So when it comes to video playback, it does support playing high definition videos at 720p as well as at 1080p. And this is how the viewing angles look like when it comes to playing a video, which are again quite wide, if not the best. Here we have some hardware information about the device. The device model number is Nexus 4, and it has an ARM V7 processor architecture, and you have 1.5 GHz of processor, which is a quad-core processor on this device. And if we take a look over the resolution, the effective resolution on the display is 768x1184, because these touch capacitor buttons does take away some part of the screen resolution. And then you have Adreno 320 GPU on this device. When it comes to the sensors, we have all these sensors which are there on this device. So you have a lot of sensors which are there. It does support navigation. It does have compass sensor. It also has the magnetic sensor. So there is no problem with the device as far as navigation is concerned. Now here we have the score for the device as far as Quadrant Standard is concerned. It scores around 3756, which is again quite okay, if not very high. And this is how the detailed scores looks like for this device, as you can see. And when it comes to the ranking, this is how the device ranks as. Now the Intel 2 benchmark score on this device is 14674, as you can see. And again, this is quite a decent score for a device like this. And this is how the CPU and the RAM have scored. RAM is little bit lower as far as these scores are concerned. And if we take a look over the bar chart over here, this is how the device ranks when it comes to comparing the device with other devices. Now the NINAMARK score for this device are again pretty impressive. As you can see, it is 59.8 fps. That means you will be able to run almost any kind of graphic intensive game on this device, including Nova 3, Modern Combat 4, Modern Combat 3. Until and unless you have the space on this device, you can run almost any kind of graphic intensive game. As far as casual games are concerned, you will be able to run all the casual games, including Temple Run, Temple Run 2, Temple Run OZ, Subway Surfer. Now when it comes to the multi-touch support, this device supports 10-point multi-touch. You also have the option of sharing internet on this device. You can create a portable Wi-Fi hotspot to share the internet, and you also have some additional features on this device like Android Beam, which will allow you to transmit data through NFC, so it does have NFC support. Now as far as OTG support is concerned, you do not have OTG support on this device, because whenever we try connecting a flash drive like this using an OTG cable, when we connect it, nothing happens on the screen. And even we have used the file manager on this device, we cannot access the contents of the flash drive. As far as battery life is concerned, this phone is pretty good when it comes to the battery life. The battery on Nexus 4 is around 2100 mAh. And it is pretty okay for a device like this, for this much of display size. And it does give you a battery backup of around more than 1 day for moderate usage. If you are a heavy user, it will last for you for at least 1 day. As far as sound enhancement options are concerned, I do not find any specific sound enhancement option. Now to finally conclude our review for Nexus 4, the LG Nexus 4, we would like to say that this device is fairly good when it comes to the overall performance it will offer to you. You can run almost all the kind of graphic intensive games, including Need for Speed Most Wanted, which we have ran on this device, Esplanade 7, Frontline Commando D-Day, Temple Run OZ, all the casual games as well as the graphic intensive game run fine on this device without any graphic lag, which we have noticed. But there is a problem with the device is that there is a little heating problem which is experienced whenever you are playing games for like more than 20 to 25 minutes. You will experience the device will become hot, especially at this particular point. And when it comes to the storage support, it does come up in two variants, the 8GB and 16GB. Again, the 16GB is only available as of now. And when it comes to the storage, you get around 12GB available as far as the 16GB storage is concerned. And again, that won't be sufficient for long. And the device does not have support for SD card, so you cannot expand the storage on this device. So that is something which most of the user won't like about this device. Apart from that, this device is fairly good. The camera performance is good. The overall device is pretty good in terms of the overall performance and the day-to-day usage. That's all from us as far as the quick hands-on review of LG Nexus 4. We would love to address any queries of yours. If you have any questions about this device, please leave them in the comment section below. You can like this video by clicking the like button below if this video helped you. You can subscribe to our YouTube video channel for more videos like this by clicking the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching this video. This is Abhishek signing off. Thank you.